Hello students, I am Monica Nagpal, assistant professor in CIET NCERT. Students, in the previous lecture we have talked about the legislature, two houses of the legislature, importance and functions of the legislature. Today we will study about the lawmaking procedure, role of parliamentary committees and the instruments for the parliamentary control over executives. The basic function of the parliament is to make laws, amend them or repeal them. All legislative proposals are brought before parliament in the form of bills. The process of lawmaking begins with the introduction of a bill in either house of the parliament. When a bill is proposed by a minister, it is called government bill, and when a non-minister proposes a bill, it is called private member's bill. Before introduction of a bill in the parliament, there may be a lot of debate on the need for introducing a bill. Bill can be of two types, money bill and non-money bill. Non-money bill can be further classified into two, ordinary bill and constitution amendment bill. A non-money bill can be introduced in any house and by any member of the house. But a member can introduce the bill in the same house of which he is a member. Money bills can only be introduced in the Lok Sabha and not in the Rajya Sabha. Money bill can only be introduced by the ministers and not by the ordinary members of the house. Let's now see the different stages in the life of a bill. The first step is introduction of the bill or the first reading. The legislative process starts with the introduction of a bill in the either house of the parliament, Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha. It is necessary for a member in charge of the bill to ask for leave to introduce the bill. If leave is granted by the house, the bill is introduced. This stage is known as the first reading of the bill. After a bill has been introduced, it is published in the official gazette. Even before introduction, a bill might be published in the gazette with the permission of the speaker. The second stage in the lawmaking process is the discussion on the bills in the committees or joint committees. The recommendation of the committee is then sent to the house. That is why committees are referred to as miniature legislatures. Then comes the third and the final stage. The bill is voted upon in the house. If a non-money bill is passed by one house, it is sent to the other house, where it goes through exactly the same procedure. As we have already discussed, a bill has to be passed by both the houses for enactment. If there is disagreement between the two houses on the proposed bill, attempt is made to resolve it through joint session of the parliament. If it is a money bill, the Rajya Sabha can approve the bill or suggest changes but cannot reject it. If the Rajya Sabha rejects the money bill or does not take any action for 14 days, under both those circumstances, the money bill will be considered passed. When a bill is passed by both houses, it is sent to the president for his assent. The assent of the president results in the enactment of a bill into a law. Students, this is how a bill translates into a law. And we have also seen here that parliamentary committees or joint parliamentary committees plays a vital role in the process of lawmaking. These committees are appointed for various legislative purposes, which not only includes lawmaking but also conducts the day-to-day business of the house. India has developed a system of parliamentary standing committees. There are over 20 such departmentally related committees. The various functions performed by the committees are varied in nature, like in-depth study of the issues, bills under consideration for making law, studying the demands for grants made by various ministries, looking into expenditures incurred by various departments, investigating cases of corruption, etc. Standing committees supervise the work of various departments, their budget, their expenditure and bills. that come in the House relating to the department. Joint parliamentary committees are also set up for working on some particular bills, and the members of these JPCs are selected from both the houses. This parliamentary committee system has reduced the burden on the parliament. Many important bills are referred to these committees for in-depth study, and after that, the committees submit the report with suggestions to the parliament. Students, in the previous lecture, we have talked about functions and powers of the legislature and have briefly discussed the function of parliamentary control over executives. Now, we will know more about the parliamentary control and instruments for controlling the executives. Here, it is necessary to understand what is executive. Executive is the branch of government responsible for implementation of laws and policies adopted by the legislature. The executive is often involved in framing of policy. In a parliamentary democracy, the executive is drawn from the party or a coalition of parties that has a majority in Lok Sabha. It is not difficult for the executive to exercise unlimited and arbitrary powers with the support of the majority party. To control the executives, some privileges have been given to the members of legislature. For instance, no action can be taken against a member for whatever the member may have said in the legislature. This is known as parliamentary privilege. The main purpose of such privileges is to enable the members of the legislature to represent the people and exercise effective control over the executive. The legislature in parliamentary system ensures the accountability of executives at variety of tasks like policy making, implementation of law or policy, and during the post-implementation stage. The legislature controls through various instruments. Deliberation and discussion is one of the powerful instruments of legislature. Legislature deliberates on the policies of the executives and discusses the ways in which policies are implemented. The question hour and zero hour, the methods where executives can be controlled by the parliament. Members can raise any question to the minister, and ministers have to respond to these questions during the question hour. This gives the members an opportunity to criticize the government and represent the problems of their constituencies. This is the most effective method of vigilance on the executives. Similarly, during zero hour, members are free to raise any matters that they think is important. But here in zero hour, ministers are not bound to reply. Second is approval and ratification of laws is another instrument. A bill can become a law only with the approval of the parliament. A government that has the support of a majority may not find it difficult to get the approval of the legislature, but it has to deliberate and negotiate amongst the members of ruling party or the coalition of parties and the opposition. In this way, legislature exercises the control through its power of ratification. Financial control. Legislature exercises control over the purse of the government. All the financial resources to implement the programs of the government are granted through the budget. Preparation and presentation of budget for the approval of the legislature is constitutional obligation of the government. The legislature may discuss the reason for which the government requires money or can refuse to grant resources to the government. It can also inquire into cases of misuse of funds on the basis of the report of Comptroller and Auditor General and Public Accounts Committees. Through financial control, the legislature controls the policy of the government. No confidence motion is the powerful weapon in the hands of the parliament to ensure executive accountability. The executive, that is the Council of Ministers, holds office only as long as it enjoys the confidence of the parliament and especially the Lok Sabha. If the Lok Sabha passes a no confidence motion successfully, the Council of Ministers is bound to resign. provision for no confidence motion exists in the Constitution itself. These are the instruments and devices of Parliament to control the executives, but basic to all is the power and freedom of the legislators as people's representatives to work effectively and fearlessly. So, students, today we have talked about the lawmaking procedure, parliamentary committees, and the parliamentary controls of legislature over the executives. In the next lecture, we will talk about judiciary. Thank you.